We are anticipating this to be the first in the series of King Tide events through the summer. We're expecting those to occur in the last weeks of May, June, and July, and a little bit in August. During those times, we are expecting even higher water levels.
This kind of event is, with sea level rise, is going to become more and more common in the future. You know, in about 10 years, we'll be having three or four of these a year.
So we're advising hotels in Waikiki to pay attention to their low elevation properties, particularly the basements. If they have electronics or power generators, things like that in the basements to secure them and try to keep the water out.
The important thing to know about king tides is that they're predictable, and we can use that knowledge of their recurrence and the time of year that they come to get out and mobilize citizen scientists to do this documentation.
It's coming upon us to be aware of what's going on, to understand what the problems are.
Where I think you might see unusual water levels is in the non-wave environments. So these are the back streets, the storm drains, marinas, and low-lying areas that aren't necessarily subject to wave inundation. They're going to see areas that will flood that have never flooded before.
The web link is www.pacificislandskingtides.org, and that is where we have the step-by-step instructions on how to register and submit photographs, and even some tips on a good documentation. But also, we've provided the tides and the locations utilizing the tide stations around the state.
As we have a lot of time to think about what our choices are and how we want to respond, how we build in the future, how we use land in the future, and I think this is going to be a sort of a prime consideration for the citizens of Hawaii for some time to come.